Welcome to episode 3 of Joystick Unbound. I'm Matt.
Robert.
Duncan.
Andrew.
Dunk Drew.
Justin, right? I'm trying to get this.
Justin, shut up. So, you guys, that was a quick introduction. That's normal. That's not normal for us. You guys want to talk about a little bit about what we're playing right now?
Yeah.
I guess I'll start. I'm playing Mass Effect 1, because everybody was like, Mass Effect. And they're like, you need to play that. And I'm like, okay. So, last week, I tried to play Mass Effect 2 first, because I had already played Mass Effect 1. I forgot about it. I got into Mass Effect 2, and I didn't know any of the characters. I didn't know what was going on, and they kept referencing things I don't remember. So, I talked.
Batman.
Yeah. So, I talked to some friends, and they said that to start over. So, I've done that. So, I'm playing Mass Effect 1. That's. The inventory system's bad. Don't like it. It's very dated. And the dialogue's okay. And some of those shaders are just fucking weird.
How old is the game now?
20 years.
Yeah.
At least 10. God.
Yeah.
10 years. It's just a baby.
Yeah. I don't know. I'm having some fun with it. I'm on the Normandy flying around, and the Mako sucks.
Mako's the best part of the game. I don't know.
You got Seth Green with you?
I do have Seth Green. Seth Green's there, and he's making snod Seth Green jokes.
Yeah. At least he's not playing with dolls.
He's not playing with dolls. Mm-hmm. And I wanted to make like Austin Powers jokes. But yeah.
There you go.
Like Joker don't. And like zip it. I was gonna do those, okay. But didn't do.
I don't think
those.
It's a dialogue option. Though.
No, I wish I was. I wish my female Commander Shepard, which I made emo as fuck, like black hair, like black. I just made her look super emo, and then in the next game, I'm gonna make her just blonde but still emo.
That'd be a really good move.
Yeah, I'm playing Paragon this playthrough because I played Renegade on my first playthrough apparently, and then I'm gonna go Renegade for the next two games.
You know what? That makes a lot of sense.
Yeah.
Given the all of a sudden resurrection of your character.
Yeah.
Charlie, spoiler alert for the...
spoilers!
Spoiler alert on like a 8-year-old game. Yeah.
Sorry about that, everybody.
But that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go Renegade for the last two. Because, I kind of feel like that's good for the character. Being like, well, I'm dead. Fuck everybody.
There is no God.
Yeah.
Screw all y'all.
So done that. I watched Rings. Over last weekend.
Okay, how was it?
Not good.
Yeah,
not good.
This is disappointing.
So I judge. I've been judging my horror movie villains by how if Sam and Dean can beat them, because because Sam and Dean destroy like gods essentially, and they can't fight. They can't fight the Ring Girl. They could not deal with her. Couldn't deal with the Ring Girl.
Is she just a ghost?
Because like if you deal with her, apocalypse happens.
What?
Yeah.
I mean, maybe. Wow.
Didn't they already do that?
Because everyone, like, if you deal with her, essentially, spoiling this piece of hog shit movie. So they end up releasing her. They, like she comes back, and they end up figuring out that her mother was kind of treated the same way. She put, like, put in a basement, and it was her mother talking to you this time, talking to the main protagonist this time. And they find the mother... They deal with the mother, and then they find the little girl's corpse, and they do the whole fucking supernatural lame thing, and they burn it. And they, instead of her, like, I guess, transcending to wherever she wants, they actually, like, unlock the evil that was inside of her. And she just started emailing everybody the Ring videos. And, like, and it hit YouTube, and it hit everybody's phones, like, on in the world.
Oh, crazy.
That's really gonna be hard to make a sequel to that one.
Yeah, so that's what they done.
Yeah, all in on that one.
But not. I don't know. It was okay. Pacing was terrible. Like it was like slow. Lasting 15 minutes, something happens.
So like red boxing.
Yeah.
Torrent it.
I could see it. Yeah, you don't steal it.
Please support the official release.
Unless you just want to. Steal.
Well, that sounds like a piece of crap.
I really don't care. I saw it at the Native American theater. Over there in Cherokee.
Huh.
Which
to you for not saying Indian.
Great. That's great.
It's an alienated
another group,
it's a nice theater though. It's really nice. They got the luck. Like, they got the so you know the our theater over there in Asheville, like the nice the grand. You know that how they have like the special seating theater? All of their theaters in Cherokee are special seating theaters.
Cinemark. Ooh, really? I went to Cinemark today and they installed the reserve seatings or whatever, and like recliners, and like they got a cool tray. Real nice.
Yeah. I hope more theaters go that way.
Yeah.
Or I want a piece of shit, like, scummy theater. I either want a really nice one or a fucking shit bag. Like, I want to sit on a needle
theater. You want the Waynesville one back?
Yeah, right? I want one of those.
Not just a regular needle. It has to be a heroin needle.
Yeah, like, it needs to already be loaded so I can get addicted.
Oh, God. This conversation again.
No!
It just circulates.
But,
you just want to be able to get addicted to it. Something every time you go to the theater,
you know, yeah. New addiction every time.
So can we turn whatever is back there? Is that a laundry? What is that?
It is oven fan.
Can we turn that off? Yeah. I guarantee you that's
pretty sure we haven't cooked anything today.
Well, actually, it's just
Gam Gam. Is it Gam Gam? Yeah, did Gam Gam turn it on?
It's Gam Gam whispering.
Motherfuck. Gam Gam didn't do a damn
Gam
thing.
Gam Gam's in heaven where she ought to be.
But that's pretty much all I've done this week. Oh, I bought a bunch of games. A bunch of 360 stuff. My friend Saba, who's totally not in this room right now, sold me some games. And then I picked through some like pawn shops and picked up some games. I got a bunch of WWE games. Got Dragon Age Origins. Played. Got Eternal Sonata. Armored Core 4. I'm trying to think of any some Dynasty Warriors games, and just some garbage to fill out my roster. But yeah, that's what I've been doing. Robert,
About Fire Emblem?
Or, no, actually, let's send it over there.
Okay,
let's send it all over right. there.
All right,
and then because they've just done so that fucking camera's just been a lot of. Yeah, I don't give a fuck what Matt's saying.
We can see you.
We need like a fucking beanbag and just like beanbag and just hit someone, and they have to talk.
I'm scared of beanbag.
We have a Vegeta.
Yeah, and we got a Goku. I think. I don't know anything about Dragon
Ball. You know who Goku is.
You damn know who Goku is.
Dragon Ball Z is.
Dragon Ball.
You're a terrible person.
You're going to hell.
Yep.
Hell's not that bad, Dragon Ball Z.
Yeah. That's true. Yeah.
Isn't it just a bunch of buff guys?
Buff guys.
You gotta fuck them.
They're not very smart. I don't know about that.
I don't think you fuck them.
You could if you want. I mean, we're not gonna stop you. Come on, dude.
I don't. What?
You broke.
Hey, Andrew, what you been doing?
What? You're up for it.
Oh, fuck. Let's turn that off. Hey, where's the buttons? Hey. Hey!
Did that break the stream, or are we offline?
What's that?
Yeah, we're good. I think we have to be streaming.
Okay.
Does that have to say start recording?
No, so it should say streaming.
Yeah, it says stop. If I click, it'll stop streaming.
Yeah, okay. We're streaming.
Weird.
Are your phone just connected?
Yeah,
I guess so.
It's we're not actually having technical difficulties. But I've just been playing a lot of the Gwent beta this last week. There's not really much, but I don't really know how to talk about that game unless you're playing.
Talk about it as if people know what it is.
Okay, it's the... They made the little mini-game from Wild Hunt. Old card game. Right now you have...
There's all the factions,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, all the factions are in the game, right?
And they have a new one?
They just added Nilfgaard. Just past the patch.
Dang.
Yeah.
Ow. Yeah, they would start with one.
Now they had...
But Skellig is broke, right?
Yeah, Skellig is broken right now. They had to...
But not in a good way, in like a poor way. That's like it's broken, just too weak,
well,
right?
Well, it was broken in the good way before, where it would you could just win. Like, if you make it... If your opponent did not end it on round two, you just won the last couple of rounds. So it was... Their whole deck was based around killing your own guys and then resurrecting them.
So it was like a suicide black deck or a recursion deck or something like that, if you played Magic.
Yeah.
Had a lot of issues with the Skellige deck in the main game, so
I never really got to play with it.
Like, you do Blood-1?
Well, yeah, I played Blood-1. I just only I did the tournament.
I only played Northern Realms. I never tried a different deck.
Well, that's the way you that's the way you won in the Wild Hunt. I think all the with the exception of Monsters. I haven't played a Monsters deck at all in the past like 4 days.
Monster deck. Days. Monster deck was my thing. I destroyed people. It's all about rushing.
That's what it's still that way, but Tell and Northern Realms have good ways to
count. Got some fucking notes over here?
Two. God damn. Two notes. Notes
me. Got some professionals.
Whoa, what kind of notes you got?
It's news notes. We're not there yet. It's actually just it's nudie pictures.
Oh, okay.
I draw nudie
pictures. Drawings.
But yeah, that's what I've been playing. Watching wise, I only watched the Santa Clarita Diet.
I watched that too. I forgot to bring that up. Yeah. That was good.
It's a really good show. It's fairly funny.
What is it about?
You can't talk about it. Oh. Watch the first episode, okay. And then you're good.
Because I heard the name, and that's it.
You need to know.
And that was on Netflix.
You figure that show out by the first episode.
Yeah.
But it has Drew Barrymore in it, and Nathan Fillion. Nathan Fillion is in it.
Oh. Is he giving her the Captain Hammer?
Maybe.
All right.
He punches boards so clean, they just come out. Yep.
Perfect. What do you think about that?
Oh, and then I've been watching Always Sunny, and it's they've had a really good season.
Yeah, yeah.
This past episode was kind of
they ought to be canceled after that. I didn't see it.
Let's just see what we can say and see if we get in trouble.
Well, apparently Charlie did the news round right before the season started, and he was talking about that he does not think that FX is aware they're even. He's like, man, we're just kind of doing our own thing now. We're just going to see, like, trying to push it, see what we can get away with.
Well,
and, see if we can trigger the FCC.
Yeah, that's how the season's been so far.
Justin's being a sack of crap again, I think.
Yeah, a little bit. All right, let's shoot it back down there.
I need a different entrance music.
We're changing it up. We're going to switch it up.
Wait, what's that sound? Something like that. I don't know. I love it though.
That's my brain breaking.
Well, Fire Emblem.
Yeah. I got the cell phone game. It's pretty good.
Yeah, I've been playing that, and then it made me want to buy the regular Fire Emblem, so I bought Birthright. And then I've been playing that a lot. I suck at it. I'm not good at it. I restarted once because I lost characters, and I was like, I just can't handle permadeath, apparently.
Yeah, well, there's a mode for not permadeath.
I know, but I want to handle the permadeath.
But you just said you can't handle permadeath.
I know,
you
so I'm trying saying, to, right? I'm trying again. I'm trying again. I'm going to do it this time. Okay, I just can't lose that one shot.
I have no clue what Fire Emblem is about. Like, what is the...
So it's a traditional fantasy world, kind of. It's a fantasy.
It's definitely fantasy. World. There's dragons.
There's dragons and magic and such.
Yeah.
And all of them are kind of like self-contained stories, sort of. Like, there's traces amount of like what happened in other games into the...
They're really about lineage at this point.
Yeah. It's like my grandfather or my father. And now I'm that prince.
The hero King Marth.
Yeah. And
I remember Marth. That's like the only character I know from that series.
Thanks to Smash Bros. Yeah.
So it's a turn-based strategy where I go, then my opponent goes. You don't move units like that. And there's permadeath.
Permadeath.
And it's really paper, rock, scissors in the...
sword beats axe, axe beats staff, stick, pointy stick, pointy stick, pointy stick.
Lance?
No, pointy stick.
Okay.
That's the official name from now on. Point stick.
You got it, buddy.
Point stick beats sword.
Yep. And then there's magic, too. So, like wind beats earth, right?
I don't know on that one.
And then fire beats something.
It is kind of...
Yeah.
I know this from Pokemon.
It's similar, yeah.
But they have, like, the same symbols. Like, there's, like, a red, a green. Woo! All that jazz. So, yeah, I don't know. It's good.
The stories are usually good from what I've
Healer's
played.
Healer's pissed
two
me off.
So far. Because they're so weak?
No, because they stay in the background and kill me. Oh. I got that guy to 1 HP. Healer heals him to full. And then they crush in on me. I'm dead.
Isn't this the one that has, like, two separate games for two different storylines of the same story?
Fates does, yes.
Yeah.
At Chapter 6, you get to choose a family. And then if you bought one, you go with them. If you bought the other. But you can unlock the other one for cheaper.
Yeah.
And then there's a third one, which is like a epilogue, I guess, really. But yeah.
One of the families are like samurai.
Yeah.
And one of the families are like kind of gothic.
Like European, medieval.
Yeah, gothic, kind of thing, medieval, yeah. European. Yeah, like thick plate mail and stuff like that.
But, I mean, so far on both Fire Emblem games I've played, the story has been enthralling, really.
Yeah,
I mean,
it's good.
Really hooky. Let me ask
you this. If you had never played one of the Game Boy Advance ones or anything like that, would you be able to pick up this game for you?
Birthright is made for that, because it's made to be easier. You level up faster. You can, like you said, you can turn off permadeath if you want.
RNG will still fuck your butt.
Yeah, I mean, prepare to restart the battle if you're not okay.
Or just the RNG of leveling up. So when you level up a character, you get random stats. So yeah, so you could your character could level up and just be like just an HP whore, or be just garbage.
At the beginning, for your main character, because this one you get to create your own character, and he's the main character of the story, unlike most of them, you can choose his bane and his boon, like what he'll level up good in, what he'll be terrible at. I chose luck because it's me in real life.
Always choose luck is the worst.
Yeah. but yeah, I mean, I recommend it. If you like strategy games at all, Final Fantasy Tactics or I don't really know. It's only the ones I really played, but
it really plays more like a board game than anything. If you break it down the way it's presented, it plays way more like a board game than anything.
Plus the graphics on it were great. The cutscenes, I mean, because the on-field graphics or whatever,
they're little chibi graphics. Yeah,
they're like Sega Genesis. You know?
It's fine though.
But then the cutscenes are amazing.
Yep.
Other than that,
it's like an anime.
Yeah.
So the gameplay's more Risk than Civilization.
Yeah, I could say that. Yeah. Sorta. Yeah. Yeah. You're not
Going to gain troops or anything.
Yeah. You're not micromanaging as much until you get down to like leveling up, like how your character wants to ascend.
Yeah. Plus, at points you're like, well, should I attack this character because he'll get the experience, or should I attack this character so they'll get the experience?
Yeah.
Because, you know, maybe you're not... You got a more power level that. There's some micromanaging if you want.
You can fuck yourself by leveling up one character really, really high and leaving the rest of your guys garbage, and then they die.
And you're like, oh.
God, well, shit.
Yeah. Other than that, I went and watched Lego Batman today.
Yeah, how was Lego Batman?
So good. So good. Hilarious. Michael Cera should play Robin in real life, I think. Probably not really, but like... That Lego Robin is the best Robin that
doesn't he keep taking his pants off?
Like, he did it once and it was hilarious.
Okay.
Yeah. And big wide eyed, like hyperactive. It's so good. There's also a lot of like other Lego movies, you'll get to see cool other characters from other movies, so that was cool. Didn't expect that as much.
Like Will Arnett's cross the best genres?
Batman. You know what? Christian Bale? Will Arnett's the best Batman.
Huh. Really?
Yeah. Yeah.
That.
Yeah.
Is he the best Bruce Wayne?
Yes.
Oh, wow. Yeah,
he sounds like the same regardless, actually. So,
he's not even like darker.
Nope. Same voice. What does not matter. He doesn't want to take the mask off. So he's just the voice, I think, is just his voice. So,
oh, okay.
He does real good.
He wore a Batman mask.
Yeah, it'd be good. I guess it's really supposed to be,
I really liked him as Batman.
Okay. Apparently, he was so good in that they were just like, "You need a whole movie."
Never seen the Lego movie.
Nope.
Yeah.
Never played a Lego game.
I played Lego like the first Lego Star.
They're really fun with people, and they're fun by themselves, but they're really fun with people. Like you got a co-op.
Ah.
I've tried to play the Lego Lord of the Rings, and as soon as I saw it, it was just Lego with
clips from the movie put in, like the voices from the movie put in. I was like,
oh, they fixed that in later games. They put more comedy and originality in them.
They're all beat 'em ups, right?
Yeah, for the most part. Light platforming.
A little bit of fun.
Not much, no.
I think I got, yeah. Let's send it over to you guys again.
You
want
to go?
I want Thel being back at them so bad.
Alrighty, well, I've been playing the Four Honor
Justin has to
beta.
Fucking edgelord it.
I just said you could go first.
Four Honor Beta.
Four Honor Beta. Okay. I had never played it before until the open beta. It's a lot of fun, but I am god awful at it. Because the way they have it is you can attack from left, right, or up top. And there's reticle that shines red from wherever your opponent's attacking. But for me, with knee-jerk reactions due to quick time training, I immediately react to that red flashing light. Their character hasn't reached that point, and I get smacked in the face.
How does it play? The only thing I know is that it's four people on each team or something?
There's different modes. That's Dominion, where you have four people on each team, and you have a middle point where your two armies clash.
Yeah, it looks like a strange game to me. Like, I don't know.
I want to play it real bad, but
is that something you'll have to have, like, other people buy the game with you?
You can buy it by yourself, but just like a Lego game or any other game, it's a lot more fun with friends. You really don't want to be relying on people
now,
you can't talk to.
Now this
in
that
is game.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Now this is online only, right? Like,
yeah, you have to have internet to play.
There's no single player.
No.
There is a story mode. There's story mode, but you have to have internet to start up the game.
Hmm. Okay.
Even if you go out and fight bots, you have to have it.
I don't know. I think I was watching some stuff about it, and it looks good. Just, I don't know if it's my... I don't know if it's going to be my whip, yo. Like, I don't know.
It's definitely not for everybody, no.
I feel like it's going to be another all four. You didn't have a group of people to play it with. It would fall off really quick. That's what happened to Evolve. Is
yeah.
People just...
Yeah,
like,
that's...
If one person from your group drops, then they're going to have a full team. And then...
That's where the dueling comes in. Cause that's 1v1 or 2v2. So you don't have to have a team to play it. You can be by yourself. It's just, you won't... I just would not recommend going into Dominion with three random people you don't know and expect to win.
But I mean, what's your general thoughts, though? Like, is it...
Is it a buy? Would you buy it?
A buy?
I mean, I'm not saying that's but like, is that a rental or a buy? You know, that kind of, from the beta at least.
From the beta standpoint, I would say rent before buying.
That's also how I was thinking I'd feel about it. Because I mean, fighting games for me, I never feel like I don't get into them enough to really justify the $60 cost.
Yeah. What does it feel like? Does it feel like a fighter? Or what is it? Because that's the odd thing about it. Because it's third person behind the head.
Yeah.
Is it, what does it feel like? Like
in dueling, it definitely feels like a fighter. It's you versus your opponent. There's no other distractions. But in Dominion, you have a whole battlefield you have to be aware of. If you're not aware of your battlefield and your surroundings, you will get destroyed.
So it's like Dynasty Warriors, just without that much massacring,
yeah,
less loose.
Because in Dominion, there's three points: there's A, B, and C. You have to make sure you're in control of all points at all times. You gain points. Go figure. But if you're not aware, and two of your points get taken over because your team's just sitting there fighting at B where all the minions are, because that's where you're going to see the most action, you're going to lose the game.
So do you?
And for all people who play the game, you have now lost the game.
So do you control your minions, or is it...
No, the minions are just...
They do what they want.
They just
random.
Run
like Titanfall, I assume.
Now, that's a game that sold me with its beta. I played the Titanfall beta, and
I loved the first one. And I really want to play the second one.
It's
good. Got around to
it's
it,
fine.
Yeah.
I'm terrible at it.
Yeah, well, we're,
I wasn't great at it.
We're
either.
Hot fucking garbage. That's what we are.
It's one of the first-person shooters that I've played since Halo that I was really...
Yeah.
I thought this was real fun.
Anything else you're playing? Did you watch anything?
Just still Warframe.
Oh, you have been playing a piss out of Warframe.
I can't help it. Can't help it. Watching, I started a new anime, Tanya the Evil. The Saga of Tanya the Evil, for the full title. It's true. It's an anime about a character fighting against God.
Okay.
Whereas God is trying to get this character to believe in him.
I feel like Justin has a snarky comment.
What you got, boy?
He wants to talk about Dragon Ball.
Nah, anime.
It's for anyone who follows comics a lot. It's kind of like John Constantine's backstory. Like, he knows God and the devil exists, but he doesn't believe in them. Only this time, God is trying to get that character to believe in them.
Okay.
All right. This character is doing everything they can to show that God is not needed, that they can live a perfectly comfortable life without them.
Okay.
Now, you won't even call them God. The character calls them Being X.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, I don't dig that name, but the rest sounds okay.
Yeah,
I can check that out.
Anime confuses me. I don't know nerdy thing animes. Sweet.
Was that English?
Nope.
Oh, okay.
No, it was English.
English?
Oh, is it my turn?
You're up.
You're the only one left.
Well, I just got done playing Resident Evil 7 after Robert moved in. And,
a little background story for you.
No, it was good. And, currently playing Fallout 4.
Did you finish Fallout 4?
Oh, this is my second. This is my second playthrough.
Okay. So you're still way behind.
Yeah. I'm all set.
Good. Oh, is this Swanger?
Hey, Swanger.
Robert needs to shave, and anime is not. Well, yeah, it's pretty good.
Some of it.
Somebody's getting off to it.
I hope somebody's getting off to us right
Swanger's
now.
Swanger's just jealous that I don't look like a terrorist.
That's true. Swanger doesn't. He don't know which side of the. The wall he wants to be on.
Oh, man. Let's divert this conversation, shall we?
Zach Galifianakis is the voice of the
that
Joker.
Was all right.
In the Lego Batman.
All right.
Apparently, they're the best porn.
Okay. Oh, sweet. So I think that's it for playing, right? Did you sell your undies, Justin, when you played Resident Evil 7?
At the beginning, it was pretty.
It sure did.
Pretty pants wetting. By the time you get to the second boss, you're Resident Evil, and once you feel like you're playing Resident Evil again, it's old territory. It all comes back.
There's still scares, but yeah,
they are.
It did become. You felt more comfortable.
We're gonna play that game in VR.
Oh, so bad.
Yep.
Just don't want to pay $500.
Creepy again, right? Towards the end, whenever that particular.
When you're stuck in the place without any ammo, and you're the other person.
Yeah.
That one, wow, that's that some good non-spoiler descriptions.
Yep. Well, at least the four of us know what we're talking about.
The one thing we haven't spoiled so far.
So, all right. I think that's what we've been playing. Let's move on to the news. Da, 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 da. I don't have a soundboard.
Why not?
I don't fucking know. I'm lame.
You got a phone.
Okay. So I'll just start off, talk about some backwards compatibility stuff on Xbox. GTA 4 is backwards compatible now, along with Lego Indiana Jones. So you can go kill brick Nazis. So that's kind of cool. Brixies, right?
Brixies?
Yeah, punch Brixies. Nazis.
Yeah, you just punch Nazis. Go out, find a Nazi, punch them.
Okay.
I'm okay with Nazi punching. And if it's brick Nazis, even better.
Yeah.
Have fun.
They explode.
That's all I got. That's it. Xbox has been nothing this week. It's been
short,
pretty
short episode this week.
It's been pretty piss poor for Xbox news. So let's go over.
What's the games with gold?
We talked about it last week.
Yeah.
Okay. The first episode we talked about Games with Gold.
Wait, is that the first episode or zero episode?
That's episode one.
We talked Nobody about saw the zero gold. Episode.
Yeah.
There's no record of it.
There is no zero episode.
No. Yeah.
It's a lot.
It didn't exist.
It's just like the cow level.
And the cake.
The cow level, and episode zero. Fuck, you tricked me. let's go over to PS4 news.
I also really liked this week. I talked about it a little bit last week.
This is not the week for gaming news.
No, apparently not.
We'll get to Andrew in a second, though.
Neo.
I'll swing back and be like,
he's got this week down.
Neo came out.
I heard it's fucking phenomenal.
That's all the reviews I've seen so far. 9.6, 9 out of 10.
I was talking to Andrew and I was like, man, PS4's looking mighty cheap right now because that Neo came out. And I was like, it looks like my jam.
Dark Souls, Samurai's, apparently it's real good. I want to play it. For Honor comes out next week, February 14th.
What's For Honor? What's that?
I'm going to smack the shit out of you.
I really don't know.
We literally just talking about it.
Oh! That's how much I give a fuck about that game.
Everybody gets to watch Matt's gears grind.
Like, I'm just like, I just don't get it, man. I don't know.
So well, does it play like a MOBA? Is that what it kind of is?
It's just the center lane. Just the center lane has minions. Everything else is all player.
Okay. is it like one hit kill? Like respawning?
No. Is respawn, but it's not one hit kill.
Someone did just point out E3 is going to be an open event.
Yeah, I had that. You stole it! That's cool, though. Yeah, we got E3 as open events. Tickets start at like 200.
Yeah, I'm not going.
Yeah, that's in, that's in California.
Did we count as gaming press yet? Can we just get
probably?
I have a business license. I could probably spin it.
We need a logo, a brand.
Maybe not right now.
But yeah, E3 completely. Actually, press passes are generally more expensive too because you get like the whole background and all that stuff. But yeah, that's an open thing now. Yeah, first time that's been that way in a few years.
They like teased it a little bit last year.
Because we do not have that thing. And we
so we got some inappropriate stuff.
Somebody wants from a certain to show some
somebody.
We have. There's no poon to show.
There's
that. Sorry
for that.
Sorry.
I don't know. Like I don't know how you clicked on us and just assumed there would be poon here.
Yeah. What did you put in our description today?
Massive poon. Come get some.
Oh, shit.
Huge moose knuckles.
Clickbait.
Guys. Stop talking about poon.
Oh, man. Divert.
Good thing we're on at 12.
I'm mad at this.
Since you don't care.
Yep.
Oh fuck! That's all the new releases that I know of. Sort of kind of PS news. Final Fantasy VII event in Mobius Final Fantasy. It takes assets from the in development remake, Cloud and the Mako Reactor Scorpion thing. So I thought that's kind of cool. You get a little taste of what the graphics might look similar to.
I wish like Square generally, like the main like the people that make the Final Fantasy games, would just get off their ass and be like. Here's a game. Like I know
it
Over
10 years.
Like they're just like, here's a teaser. We changed our mind. Here's something else.
Yeah.
And then they gave us 13, right? Which was a hallway, right?
Most of it was a hallway, yeah. And then by the time it wasn't a hallway,
it was over.
You didn't care.
They are not interested in making video games anymore.
13.2 was good. 13.2 was good. I don't care.
And they just want you to interact with them just enough to call it a video game.
It's like Metal Gear.
I mean, they're
at least Metal Gear.
Except
for
Phantom Pain.
Yeah,
Metal Gear's good.
I mean, there are other studios under Square, like Crystal Dynamics and stuff like that. Yeah. That's Square, right?
Yeah.
They do great games.
Yeah.
Tomb Raider.
The Avengers games that talked about.
Yeah, we talked about last week.
Were you not here last week?
This is the week before that. We played D&D.
We played D&D. Yeah. We nerded out on D&D last week.
Yeah.
So that's it.
That's all I had. Yeah, I looked.
All right, Andrew. Bring it home.
So do we want to start with TV or do we want to start with
That's up to you, buddy. I have TV wrote down as number 4. So it's up to you.
But he's not, like, a dictator.
I'm not.
He's a dictator type.
You know what? I'm going to go the other way. I'll go to movies first.
Let's build that wall.
Well, actually, if we're going to talk about that. So Saturday Night Live is doing amazing.
I loved the Melissa McCarthy sketch with whatever the fuck his name was. It was hilarious. I don't know him at all. Spicer, I think.
That's
I know nothing. I don't know how accurate it was, but I thought it was hilarious. I don't even really like Melissa McCarthy all that much, but
I thought it was hilarious. I actually kind of despise Melissa McCarthy. I'm not a huge fan of it of her.
I thought sketches were fun though.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't think she's very funny.
Sorry. I mean, like I said,
we have a question in the comments.
Sure.
Okay.
Do you think PC, Xbox, or PS4 is better, and why?
Okay, I have no preference when it comes to gaming consoles. I own pretty much everything out there, minus a PS4, just because every time I want to buy a PS4, I end up, something happens. It disappears. But I even own a Wii U.
The only reason I don't have a PS4, I already have a backlog on one. I'm not going to be able to catch up both.
I think the only thing PS4 might have over Xbox, and it's actually not even necessarily, that's a taste thing, really, but they got more exclusives, I think, that
appeal
to me personally, but, I mean, it might not be for
you. But then fucking PC runs in, kicks the door open, and leg drops you. That's what happens.
Look what I got!
You guys just slept
with
PC.
But it doesn't matter. Just pick what you like, pick the brand you want, and just stick with it. And then when you get done with their exclusives, go into the tertiary one.
Seems like a lot of people.
Well, that's cool.
Oh, so we have PC Master.
You PC it up, and I'm cool with that. You know, I have a pretty powerful rig, too. So
you're not helping either.
No, I brought in there with me.
I mean, when you can buy, 6, 7, 8 games for, $1 on Humble Bundle, I mean, PC is a bang for your buck once you get the PC.
But, I mean, I don't know. I have everything, so I don't have a preference.
Rich.
Okay, that's me. That's what happens when you have no kids and a disposable income. You just buy everything.
Commodore 64.
Yeah, I don't have one of those. So I should buy one.
I have no kids and I still have
one. So let's talk about some TV, Andrew.
Okay, so we talked about Santa Clarita.
Yeah, really good. Yep.
Yeah,
solid.
Really good show. Apparently there was a Samurai Jack season 5.
What is the Samurai Jack you speak of? That's my childhood, it really is.
Yeah.
So it's good. Good. I'm glad it's coming back. Set in the same world as Powerpuff Girls, just in the future.
That's gone.
Yep.
That's Argon Wild.
Yeah, hold on.
You looking at titties over there, bro?
He's gotta find the poon.
Pages of tits.
Oh, sweet.
Somebody did ask for poon. So.
Samurai Jack's good. I'm glad it's coming back.
Jindy Kartikoffee? What's his fucking name?
What the fuck?
The creator's name? Jindy Kartikoffee?
I don't know. I just know it's a cool cartoon.
He did Clone Wars. He did Dexter's Lab. He did all the good cartoons back in the 90s. All
right. Early 2000s. I like that kind of. I don't know.
He's good.
Johnny Bravo.
I don't think he did Johnny Bravo. I don't know.
Did you not say Johnny Bravo?
I saw
that. Johnny Bravo!
I don't think he did Johnny Bravo. No.
I saw Johnny Bravo. Yes, it's real good.
I swore you said Johnny Bravo.
He has the hair and he whips around. He has the fucking comb and he hits on the ladies.
He does the monkey.
He's really bad with the ladies, though. I guess he looks very fantastic. I don't know.
He lives with his mother. That's the worst thing.
Ladies don't like that.
Ladies don't like people live with their mothers.
No.
Go panty drawer.
The new Samurai Jack looks like it's supposed to be more violent and for adults, which is good because we grew up
on it. Because we're the ones adults.
Yeah.
What else we got?
The Stranger Things season 2.
Yeah, trailer came out. Yeah, teaser.
Little Ghostbusters outfit on.
Yeah. It looks like Halloween.
Something like that. Comes out. Yeah, Halloween as
well. Yep.
I kind of watched that series.
You haven't watched it yet?
No.
It's really
good. I watched the first episode and I was so enthralled.
If you like D&D, E.T.,
Steven Spielberg.
I like all of those things.
And, an 80s horror, like the way that...
Yes.
Yeah, then you'll like...
I watched the first episode. I really enjoyed it. I just didn't get around to
there's,
the rest
there's
of it.
Even like, you know, there's a lot of cool stuff. There's like there's the teenage banging in there. And then she gets sucked into the pool. And there's all kinds of stuff. It's really good stuff.
Spoilers.
That's not. That's came out
some
a year
teenagers
ago.
Teenagers bang and something gets sucked
there's,
up.
There's a fucking. There's a fucking. No, I'm a 3 month spoiler guy. If it came out past 3 months ago, you're then there is no spoilers.
Minus rings, because it was terrible.
Yeah, rings. Rings. You get. You get out of here.
We have another question.
Sure.
Okay.
What did you think? And I don't. I'm not sure how to word it. What did you think of Netflix, Dear White People?
It was a show on Netflix.
Okay, I didn't know the white people. I didn't see it.
I haven't watched it. No.
I have no idea what that is.
Apparently, the question was if it was racist or not.
Oh, I can't. So, I can't comment.
Yeah,
sorry.
Tell us why you think it's racist.
Yeah. Top us. Yeah. If you think it's racist, let us know, and we'll debate that.
God damn you. just for the record, I'm not going to dignify it with Goku would win. Okay,
just Goku all day. You guys don't need to know what the question is.
Oh, we know
it's
that,
Goku versus Superman. I'm sure.
No, it's Goku versus Hulk Hogan.
Oh, Hulk fucking Hogan, man!
Hulkamania runs wild.
No, he can bitch press a planet on his worst day.
Hulk Hogan probably could too, but we didn't let him try.
Well, Goku's still going strong. How about the Hulkster?
He'll be back next year.
Huckster's making
maybe this year.
Huckster showed his ding dong and made millions. Okay,
dropped
yeah.
a leg drop on Gawker.
Yeah,
we sure did.
But like ripped off an NWO shirt. Like it was.
Yeah, he won so much money. Millions. So much money.
And then Gawker went under
after
that.
Yeah.
Like immediately.
They're not
yeah,
good
he
anyways.
He had to work another day as life before,
terrible.
But now he really.
Yeah,
his grandparents.
He's done.
His grandkids don't have to work.
Yeah.
He's so rich his grandparents are.
Because they're dead.
Oh,
come on.
Poor Gam.
Apparently, Chuck Norris would win.
Okay.
Chuck Norris would not win.
Come on, man. He doesn't go swimming in the ocean.
They might just make friends.
Or Goku would just give him one quick punch and they all explode.
Hulk Hogan turn heel on him.
Yeah. Oh, man, I remember that night.
He'd be Hollywood Hogan on.
So much trash in the ring that night.
It ruined my childhood.
Did it? Did this come wrestling hour?
I was a Hulkamaniac.
Oh, man.
He's also the one that made me realize it wasn't the punches weren't real. It was his fault.
You idiot.
I was a kid. Everybody thought it was real at first. Come on.
Oh, yeah.
I think because I had seen the interviewer. He's like, yeah, like it's all fake. Like but some of the injuries you get when you're just fucking mean.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, they do some real shit.
Mick Foley blew a fucking tooth through his esophagus up through his nose. I mean, that's real.
Oh, my God. All
right. Patrick Swayze in Red House versus Walker, Texas Ranger.
Roughhouse. Does this just become a death battle show?
I think so.
Anybody got some clay?
I want to say Patrick Swayze.
Well, he is a ghost.
Yeah.
In both of them.
Did Walker, Texas Ranger kill him?
Maybe. Doesn't he inhabit Whoopi Goldberg eventually?
Yes.
Doesn't he possess her?
I'm
so you're going to want to show down between Chuck Norris
and a ghost.
Just like he possesses Whoopi Goldberg?
Whoopi! Whoopi!
Whoopa!
Yeah, I can't talk today.
That's how our name spelled. It's fine.
We didn't do our vocal exercises.
Can we go back to the TVs?
It's kind of related.
This is still technically TV.
They were on TV. What else do you want?
Yep.
What else? All right, Andrew, start us back up.
So Netflix announced the Castlevania series.
Yeah. I'm very interested in that.
It's going to be rated R as fuck.
Alucard.
That's what he said. That's Dracula backwards.
Spoiler! Now, do we know who's going to be the protagonist? Is it going to be...
Belmont.
I'm assuming a Belmont. Yeah.
It is. It's about the Belmonts.
I'm assuming it'll be Dracula somewhere in there.
I'm assuming there'll be a Belmont and a Dracula, and there'll probably be a slutty lady.
It is the... They said they wanted to make it the Game of Thrones. They're comparing to Game of Thrones.
Oh, man.
Whoa.
Yeah.
That's a big statement.
Yeah. I mean, that's a big statement since you're stuck in a fucking castle the whole goddamn time.
I guess he's going to fuck his siblings in the castle.
Is there a different pair of tits in every room of the castle? Because that'd be pretty cool.
This show ain't for kids.
There's three things that goes on in Dracula's castle. Titties, upside down places, and burning children alive. That's the three. Yeah.
Now, in Castlevania 2, that wasn't true. You were outside the castle for some of the game.
But you're still on the grounds of the castle, right?
You're in the castle town.
Okay.
I don't know.
I know that there was that one where you're Alucard's friend or whatnot with the DS where you had to do the seals.
Oh, it was really good.
Yeah, those are great games.
Yeah. But, I remember you playing them at the shop.
Yeah. Yep, fucking Metroidvanias.
Mm-hmm.
Good stuff.
They coined the term. What else you got?
Show me all you got. Legion.
Legion.
Yeah.
Oh, now this is...
You say, what is the show?
Yeah, what is it?
Like, this is kind of my turf.
Okay.
Comic you go for it.
Yeah, yeah.
It's DC, right?
Marvel.
Is it?
I'll punch you.
I thought it was DC.
Do
it's
it.
X-Men.
Oh, I don't know anything about the X-Men.
It's
X-Mans, right?
X-Guys.
The X-Dudes.
PC is X-Person.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you
can't X-Fellas.
No, that's still...
X-Fellers?
No, that's still pandering towards the male patriarchy.
It's
X-People. X-Person.
X-Y'all.
Anyway, okay,
X going to give it to you.
X going to give it to you.
Oh, man. Okay, so Legion is about the comic book character of the same name. He is a mutant with split personality disorder. Each personality has its own unique power. Now, I don't know how much they're going to go with his original backstory, because that would include a Professor Xavier character. I don't know if they have to use him right now.
Yeah, it's set in the same universe.
Do you say Xavier or Xavier?
I'd say Xavier.
Okay.
Like a nice little Xavier.
Okay.
Daddy. Anyway. Other than that, I don't really know much about what the show is going to cover. I mean, obviously, they're going to do his origin over.
Now, is this from the Marvel like studios?
It's the same people who do the rest of the Marvel.
It's from the people who do the Fox stuff. Yeah. X-Men.
So it's Fox.
It's Fox. Yeah. X-Men, I mean, Marvel gets a name on it, but I think that's all they get.
Okay. I didn't know if they were doing the Spider-Man thing and all that stuff.
No, Fox.
Okay. That's Sony, right?
Yeah, yeah. Fox is real stingy.
They need to quit being so goddamn stingy.
Yeah, I agree.
It's theirs.
I didn't see that one.
Okay.
Sucks.
Anyway.
Legion's supposed to be really good from what I read, though. The first episode got reviewed real well.
Is that going to Netflix? Is that going to
it's on FX.
It's on the FX?
It's an FX show, yeah.
Okay.
So they'll have a little bit more free reign.
Did you have that show? Taboo?
Tom Hardy. Tom Hardy, yeah.
Yeah.
Ridley Scott's the director.
That's crazy. That's one that I just missed. I didn't hear about it coming out until it's already been out.
Same, yeah.
Months.
I didn't hear about it till just now.
After those two names alone, I'd want to watch it. I don't know what it's about, though.
Tom Hardy, that's a wrestler, right?
That's Bane.
Yeah. Oh.
That's Bane and Mad Max.
I know.
Oh, sorry.
It's
sorry.
A fucking bit.
Sorry. Sorry. Sometimes you don't know people, right?
It's a 50-50 shot.
Yeah, sometimes Matt is like... Do you know who
you literally hear it sometimes like you is this people.
Oh man.
You gotta get that one. Alright.
Yep.
All right, I'm gonna go on.
I'm sorry, you're wearing socks?
Yeah.
Those are Nintendo socks.
I'm gonna go on to movies.
Oh.
Okay.
Bada bing.
Let's see.
I think they said that on The Sopranos.
Perfect.
I don't know if it's been up for a long time or not, but apparently it became big again this past week. The script that they were shopping around to make the Halo movie in 2008.
Yeah, they got leaks, right?
Yeah, you can read it online. I said they're in Reddit. It's just the game, basically. But they make some weird changes. They didn't need to be named.
In Halo 1. We're talking about the Halo 1 script. Okay.
Yeah. And then,
we getting beers?
I got
goddamn bell beers are in there.
You want
exit stage
yes, please.
Right? Oh, never mind.
Thanks, Hughes.
Return stage left.
Give me one of those red ones.
Sorry, folks. Taking a beer break.
Papa needs his alcohols.
So I assume that they're still not making the movie ever.
Not
especially since Halo has lost a lot of the heat.
Lost some of the heat.
Yeah. Heat's the wrong word.
Using wrestling terms.
I know.
Well, they're made.
Shut up, disembodied voice.
They made a couple of things. All the Halo movies.
I liked it. I don't think it was like it wasn't super good, but I enjoyed it.
I liked the what was the pill thing?
What?
The miniseries. Hunt the Truth. Really liked Hunt the Truth. Thought that was great.
Didn't see that.
Didn't connect to the game.
To the game at all, but it had a pill.
Yeah.
From Key and Peele.
Oh really?
Yeah, he was like a reporter reporting on. So apparently Mass Chief busted into an embassy and killed like all of these like ambassadors. And he was reporting on that and then breaking down what happened there, and then like Ani came in and covered it up as he was went to the public about it, and then Ani's like, "No, you're a fucking liar, and this is the reason why we're going to incarcerate you."
Because I think the official story was that Chief had killed them, but he went to looking into it, and he was doing like an Oni ops or something.
But they were spies, right?
Yeah. And
that sounds cool.
He was trying to clear. I think he was trying to clear Chief's name.
The more I think about Hunt the Truth, the more I think that maybe that whole piece wasn't set in Halo 5. It was more set during the initial wars, like against humans.
I can see that.
Yeah,
we got way off movies. Has anyone else besides me seen the It Comes at Night trailer?
I broke down and watched that trailer because I heard that they didn't show anything really.
Yeah,
and it looks kind of creepy, kind of scary. Very and my kind of scary too, where it's like more anxiety more than anything.
What would you call it? Scary, spooky?
Spooky, scary, spooky, very scary. Spooky.
Okay.
It looks like 200 haunted.
Yeah, very haunted, very spooky.
200 haunted?
Yeah. That's what Donkey would call it. At least 200 haunted.
What's it called? It comes at night?
It comes at night. So the trailer has right like there. Just like a family ladies. So the trailer just has like a family sitting around a table basically being like, "Hey, we got to go get fucking supplies." We're like, "Well, it's almost night time, so fuck that shit." And right. There's a dog, and there's a bunch of stuff that happens out in the woods.
Okay.
Yep.
I'll watch the trailer.
That's what the fucking trailer is. Like,
I believe you. I need to watch the trailer.
And there's a lot of, like, anxious music. Like, yeah. Burr, 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 shit's going down.
No jump scares.
No.
Like anybody that. I know in it?
Is this kind of like an It Follows thing?
I think it's going to be like an It Follows kind of thing.
Joel Edgerton in it.
Okay. Yeah. Okay.
He's the only one that I know of.
Looks like I'm drinking just grenadine.
Speaking of Castlevania, this is Dracula.
Blah.
He's retired.
What nah?
I'm Fatula.
He's retired from the castle and started a podcast.
It's shitty. It's not a good thing.
Mumbling.
Justin is the mumblingest. He's about ready to throw down some bad poetry here in a minute.
I want to get some dark sunglasses.
Fucking Def Jam over here.
I'm going
to
put
down
a rocket before I flip solo.
Oh, man. This is recorder from middle school.
So, World War Z2 and Friday the 13th got pulled.
Both got pulled.
What is happening with them? That last Friday the 13th. Reboot. I loved it.
I loved it.
I thought
too.
It was so good. Yeah. I think that company sucks. Maybe is that the problem? Is it Brad Fuller?
I mean,
is that his name?
Maybe
is it Michael Bay. Maybe I think it's Michael Bay.
Jason X 2. That's what we need.
So, a lot of people bash Jason X. There was a... He has a scene...
Is that the one where he, like, freezes the woman's face?
That was a cool scene. That was a cool scene. I don't care what anybody says.
My favorite scene is when he's in the hologram room and he stuffs the lesbian, like, teenagers into a fucking, like, sleeping bag and then beats it into a tree. Yeah.
That movie had some cool kills. Like, it may have been a piece of crap movie, but it has cool kills.
Sweet kills in it, yeah.
I believe the game's still going strong.
Oh, yeah.
It looks good.
Yeah. And we was dicking around with some gameplay on that the other day. I was looking at it.
Mm-hmm. They announced that Matt Reeves is going to be the director of the Batman.
Is he actually going to? Last I read, it was like he was in the contention or whatever.
Well, that's... Like, he's... realistically, yeah, he's still in contention, but the way it's been, it's basically been announced. He's the one.
I mean, that's awesome, though. Yeah. He did still have Cloverfield, right?
Yeah, he did Cloverfield, Dawn of the Planet of the Apes, and he's doing War of the Planet of the Apes.
Justin's losing his mind.
Did he do Cabin in the Woods? Was that, or he was just a producer on that one?
Calm down, Jesse.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
That was Joss Whedon.
I'm sorry for the production value.
Drew Goddard was the director on that, right? Because I know Joss Whedon it was involved. I didn't know if he directed it.
But Drew Goddard is also the guy. From what I understand, he's the one that took over Pacific Rim. I may be completely wrong. Stephen the
Knight. Yep.
Name drops. Nobody's going to know what you're talking about.
Somebody will. Yeah. Maybe. Ain't Andrew knows.
Look at him. You know.
Oh, and then last... weekend at the Super Bowl, right?
Yeah,
we got a whole
this Super Bowl,
whatever that is.
Is that about bowling?
Sports? Yes, yeah.
I think it's about bowling.
Yes, yeah, bowling.
You can't say Super Bowl.
Is that copyrighted?
Oh fuck!
Shit.
Super Bowl.
So anyway, yeah, the Super Bowl.
Patriots won. You didn't know.
I don't talk about
spoiler
it.
Spoiler alert.
We got a lot of new. Like just the movie ads with the Guardians.
Yeah,
trailer. Yeah.
That Guardians.
With, okay, we had the
Stanley's confirmed his cameo.
Yeah, the new Transformers with Nazis and Knights. And
yeah, that's a thing.
I have no idea what's going on with those.
No, nobody does. I haven't enjoyed them. No Star Wars though.
No Star Wars.
That's surprising.
I think I think it's too early.
I mean, May the 4th. That's when.
Oh, yeah. I guess that makes sense. Yeah.
Yeah. That's my guess. But they also had the Dead Man Tell movie trailer.
I don't know what that is. Oh, Pirates. Trivia,
yeah.
Yeah.
I've seen the trailer in theaters.
Yeah, I saw the.
And
my wife's a big Pirates fan, and she showed me the new trailer. I try to stay away from trailers usually.
Right.
And she was like, "Oh my god, all these people! Look, Orlando Bloom's back in this." So I was like, "All right, that's cool."
Oh really?
Yeah.
See, because the theater trailer didn't show that. So.
Yeah. Yeah. There's the Orlando Bloom, and then there's the Queen Anne's Revenge.
Yeah.
Huh.
And yeah.
Joe Jack.
Yeah, like, right. Like, covered in oil either oil, mud, or feces.
Maybe a mixture.
Yep. Wow. But he had a sack of coins.
That's all he cares about.
He's a pirate. Yeah. I expect as much.
I enjoy the series. So.
No, I really like it.
I mean, the fourth one was mediocre, but I still enjoyed it.
Yeah, it's fun. I like the descent of back into piratehood. That Barbossa had. Barbossa's like just a freely laced man, and then he turns into a fucking pirate. He's done. I like that transition.
Didn't they cut his leg off in between
World's End? And... Yep. Yeah, he has a peg leg.
Let's
call him Peg.
Hey, Peggy Hill.
Yeah.
Who's my favorite character of King of the Hill?
She has nice feet, apparently.
Yep, she's my favorite King of the Hill character.
Or big feet, I'm not sure.
Kevin Smith, no Clerks 3 or Mallrats sequel.
Is that fucking needed? Hey, off camera, do you want to talk about this?
No.
Look, I can summarize his feelings. He thinks Kevin Smith is a terrible writer and director and should stick to TV. That would be his opinion.
That's a really... reduced version of what I said.
But accurate? Like, I like Kevin Smith as a guy. He's great. Like, his talk, anytime he talks, he's great.
Does that motherfucker wear anything but hockey jerseys?
No.
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 His jorts, man.
Jorts and hockey shirt.
Yeah.
But, so now, Clerks 3 he's not doing because somebody dropped out of it. So it had to be a lead, which means it was Randall or Dante, right?
It was Anderson.
It was Randall?
Because he didn't want to do Clerks 3 either. Like, he was what was holding that up. Because he doesn't really want to be an actor in the whole thing. It's just, Kevin kind of makes him do it.
Right.
And I think this time he finally was like, no, I really don't.
So the script must have not been very good, I'm guessing, for someone who, I mean, he could just not want to be an actor, and that's one thing, but...
Yeah,
and then you got Mallrats, a TV show. No networks are picking up. You can't get what Hulu or Netflix or Crackle. Crackle wouldn't pick it up.
Yeah, wow. Crackle, the one who made fucking Joe Dirt 2.
Yeah,
that
Dirtay.
Joe Dirt 2. Man, what a hunk of shit!
Amazing piece of cinema.
Did not need to be made.
Yeah,
it was wonderful. It was absolutely.
So what's happening? Maybe he wasn't that great in the first place, but I enjoyed his movies. I got a lot of nostalgia and joy out of it. I love the first Mallrats.
Oh.
Not Joe Dirt.
I thought I was like...
He didn't make no movies, I don't think.
It's like, the fuck?
So what's happening that he can't get anything made at this point? Is it because of that last movie? What was it?
Yoga Hosers?
Yoga Hosers? I heard it was really fucking bad. I liked Tusk.
You watch Tusk?
Cool. I like Tusk. Yeah. I think it was weird and interesting and just cool.
But then you have like fucking Red State. Like,
Red State was great. Yeah.
would never know what's a Kevin Smith movie.
Yeah, no.
Maybe he should stay out of comedy.
I'm trying to serious.
Maybe that's the problem. He's got a juvenile sense of humor.
But maybe that's the problem.
It works for stand up, but in a movie.
Well, when he's talking, though, he's, like, inspirational and shit. Like, he talks to the nerds who don't do anything with their life, and you're like... Huh, you're that guy who was successful that I could do that.
Yeah.
I can make crappy movies.
I mean, yeah. Like he's like a fallen hero almost.
He retired and now he's coming back and he can't get anything made after Yoga Hosers. It's disappointing.
That would be like Miyamoto putting out like a bad like Mario game. You know, like
yeah. Or not being able to be told no, you can't make that. We're not going to pay for that.
Yeah.
Wow. How bad was that?
Huh?
Yeah, like, Johnny Depp is what came back for Yoga Hosers. Played the same character he did in Tusk.
Yeah, he played the detective.
Yeah.
Is that supposed to be like the same? Is it still like the same universe, like all of his movies?
It's not
the U.S. universe.
Yeah,
as far as I know, but it is like he had like a.
Oh, that was a fucking, that was a whole fucking dance number in damn Clerks too.
I love that. I love Rosario Dawson dancing.
Only thing I'm saying is that roof would cave in.
Fucking, he did like a Canadian trilogy thing. That's what that was. Yeah, Tusk and
Yoga.
And he had one more.
I don't know if it's coming now.
Probably not.
Why don't you just make a hockey movie?
Was the third one about hockey, actually?
Wow.
I can't remember.
Maybe my Ducks.
With Kevin Smith?
Yep, Kevin Smith made my Ducks. Someone got Emilio Estevez out of wherever he is.
I would like to know what he's doing.
I
think he's the better Estevez.
Probably slaying pussy.
Probably.
Probably.
Yeah.
It's lined up the door right now.
Yep. Anyway, what do you got? Anything else? We got
The last thing is Infinity War started filming yesterday, and
Tom Holland was on set.
Now this is the is this going to be the combo like with the Guardians and we got the Avengers and
like
we got
everybody?
Hang on, I'm gonna find the cast list for this. Hang on,
I'm sure I read something
okay.
about.
While he's looking, for, go ahead.
It's everybody.
Isn't Thanos the lead? The movie
I mean, he's going to have to be the main villain. I mean, it's Infinity War. Like,
yeah, he's definitely the main villain.
Okay. Confirmed cast list. Yeah, Robert Downey Jr., Chris Evans, Mark Ruffalo, Jeremy Renner, Chris Hemsworth, Paul Bettany, Elizabeth Olsen, Josh Brolin, Chris Pratt, Zoe Saldana, Bradley Cooper, Vin Diesel.
Vin Diesel? Yeah, Groot.
He's Groot, yeah.
Oh, right.
Benedict Cumberbatch. Chadwick Boseman, Sebastian Stan, Anthony Mackie, Tom Holland, Stellan Skarsgård, Peter Dinklage, Benicio del Toro, Karen Gillian? I don't know that. I would murder that name if I tried it.
So you gave it to Justin?
He doesn't care if he does or not.
Tom Clementine.
There's sure, no way.
There's a fart noise.
Dave Bautista, Kobe Smulders, Scarlett Johansson.
Now what the fuck is she gonna do?
she can kill aliens.
You ask that in like every movie she does with the Avengers.
Not officially confirmed. Paul Rudd, Samuel L. Jackson, Evangeline Lilly, Brie Larson, Idris Elba, and Tom Hiddleston. That's that cast.
Ooh, boy.
I feel like they just they took a dump truck full of money and they just dumped it on the ground.
You know, it was a Reddit post, so you know who knows how accurate it is, but some guy was doing like math about it, and he was like, "Yeah, the math thing." He was like, "What they make is just not even a problem with how much that movie's gonna make." They make so much money that it's like a drop in the hat.
Yeah,
which is crazy considering how much they make.
Well, like if they drop $500 million on that for both movies, each one's gonna make a billion.
Yeah,
like it's just going to.
Yeah,
that's nuts.
Every time a Marvel movie comes out, it breaks a record. So
that's crazy money. And I'm just sitting over here hoping that there's Marvel characters in the, the Kingdom Hearts?
In Star Wars.
Yeah. Well, you know, in 7 years, when you get Kingdom Hearts 3, you'll find out.
You know, I'm...
There'll be a couple more compilation games.
That game's coming out this year. I'm thinking that game's coming out this year.
Maybe.
They're never going to do it. They're going to keep jerking this off until...
He said it's not even close to done. That's what he said about that in Final Fantasy VII. He says, not even close to done. That's ridiculous. You guys have been making this game for so long. Come on, guys.
Just let it out already.
So, anybody got any other news?
I remember Destiny 2 is somehow on track to release this year.
Yeah. There's some stink about that, right? So, Bungie was told by EA that they have to put out Destiny 2 or they lose half of Bungie's stock portfolio. EA's taking half of the company.
That's fucked up.
That's how that works.
And that was in their contract, is they have to produce Destiny 2 by 2017 or half of the company's owned by EA.
They just did an expansion not long ago, right?
Now mark my fucking words, we're going to have a shit half-produced game again.
Yep.
So it really will be the sequel to Destiny.
Mm-hmm. Bye.
that's our studio audience.
I'm looking forward to at least seeing what it is. I'm not gonna buy it day one like I did Destiny.
No, I like.
Yeah, wait like 3 months and then you might have a game.
More like six, man.
That's sorry. I only played a little bit, but the gameplay was real fucking
it
awesome.
It was.
But I guess if you get into the MMO aspect, well, it might have been the problem,
that's when
right?
you know, and Bungie does this, I think, with a lot of their games, is they make sure the game's fun, and they build on top of that. And with Destiny, that's what they've done. They made sure the game was fun, and then they're like, fuck, this comes out in 3 months. So let's quickly build things. There was parts of that game where you could be like, you could go to where, like, Taken King was supposed to be, And you just can't go there. It's just empty.
Yeah.
But you can get there. It's built. Like, Taken King was supposed to be in that fucking game.
Well, like, there's a lot of stuff behind that game. Like, apparently they had a story. And then Joseph Staten left, the guy who wrote all the first three games.
Peter Dinklage left too, right?
He left. Yeah, they replaced him with Milton.
People had a lot of problems with him, and
I thought he was fine.
I didn't hear any problems. I don't know what the problem was. He's a robot. Like, what the fuck are you
He's a fucking robot. Yeah.
Yeah.
Gotta get the robot voices down.
But yeah, like, the lead writer left. There's, like, rumors that they just cut, like, storyline. Apparently each class was supposed to have its own starting area.
And,
like, each class and race I guess each race, and then like your class would go from there. But each race is supposed to have a different starting off point, and they ended up cutting the other two out. And you just have the one starting point for all the races and classes.
What a drop ball! Like,
yeah, I haven't done a lot of stuff coming out now. Something gets cut. There's a huge chunk missing. You can go back to Metal Gear. That entire last chapter was cut. Yeah. Because of that whole...
So I got a little bit of news on the tabletop front. War Machine had a new big rules drop.
Another, like, full errata?
Well, one character got completely errated, like one caster. Apparently she had been winning tournaments for, like, the last 2 months, just solid straight. Wow. Like, no one played anything else. And she got nerfed to the fucking ground, and now no one's going to play her. It was a big to-do, too, because she was, like, a $30, $40 model. So everybody's like, I bought this model, now I can't play it. And
I like how that's how nerfing that's works how with games. Work. You're like, either you're too strong or you're too weak. They never hit that middle ground.
Yep.
Of course, and, if you're the person who's playing them because they're too strong, then you're just pissed because you're not as strong as you were. Yeah. So who knows?
And they came out with new army boxes this year. For like, you can get into that game for $150 now. You can get like
Is that all?
Yeah. Well, I mean, for that much for that many
here,
miniatures.
Here's my debit card.
For that many miniatures, right. That's really cheap.
Yeah.
I mean, compared to like a 40K. Then you're looking at $100, and you still don't have, like, you get two, like, fifths of an army. So, but 40K, there's also rumors that they're going to put out a new starter box this year, which I'm interested if it has, I might buy if they have, what is that, Space Wolves in it. Because I like Space Wolves.
I like the name of Space
Marines. Yeah, they're so essentially, like the fucking, like, Space Marines with, like, the big armor, like the Warhammer-y Space Marines. Yeah. Just that, but with wolves.
Okay.
Like fucking dead wolves and shit. That's the ones at PETA. Did we talk about the PETA thing?
I don't think so. With the fake fur?
No, we talked about it at work. Oh. Fucking PETA. So PETA... So...
Let's hand it out of the group. Here we go.
So fucking PETA... contacted GW and wants them to take off all dead wolves off the Space Wolf models. It's a fucking model! It's plastic or metal, man! And they want to take off any symbolism of dead animals from. Oh, also, like, Space Wolves, they have, like, these little floating chariots that wolves, like, lead, like snow sled kind of things, and they want those to be removed too.
Fuck PETA.
Right?
Official record, fuck PETA.
Yeah, but...
You're a piece of shit terrorists.
They really are. Sorry. They're a terrorist.
But, I mean, really, it's ridiculous. Oh, games fucking got some dead wolves. Ooh.
You can't fucking say that.
No, I fucking said it. Come at me, bro. Shit's stupid.
Robert's opinion is not that of the group.
No, it is. You guys are being stupid.
Robert's opinion is not the opinion of my house. Anybody?
No, it is.
Any animals in the house?
Well, they won't hurt your animals.
We love the animals.
At least not at first. They'll take them and then put them to death.
Yeah, like, that's what they do.
Because that's what the fuck they do.
Or rip brains apart.
We're getting hot. Robert's been triggered, man.
Sorry.
I kind of want to take a break anyway.
Okay. We'll be back, but just put us on the break screen.
Okay, when we come back, do we just want to go straight into the...
Yeah, straight into topic two, which is fantasy!
Fuck PETA! Oh, shit, what?
We're back.
That's his picture,
right? All right. Anyway, so we're going to hang out here and take your questions. So if you're watching, please hit us up in the chat room. Anything. Anything goes right now. So.
Oh, fuck.
It's a free-for-all, people.
It's a free-for-all. But in the meantime, I have some shout-outs I want to do. Roker Eject. Thanks for following us.
You're a cool guy.
You're a cool guy. And third girl, mate Taylor. And third mate Taylor, who is apparently on a ship, maybe.
Yeah.
I mean,
sounds like it.
Yeah.
Or maybe they want to be on a ship.
Might as well.
Want to be on a ship?
But then they don't sound like they really aspire for more than third mate.
Yeah, I don't know who asked this.
It seems we have our
first. I don't know who asked this.
Okay.
is there any Dragon Ball Z news?
I don't know. What's how about that Dragon Ball Z news?
What you got, Justin?
There's also another question which I think I can segue into this. female Brawl is still not revealed, but we are coming up on the tournament of the All the Galaxies, so she's coming, people. She's coming. And also, on a weird side note, Goku would totally beat Hulk Hogan. No matter how much Hulkamania is running through him, he would still beat him.
Not true.
And we're done.
It's not true. Hulk Hogan would totally win, Goku.
You can't stop the Hulkamania.
All right, Screw Attack, if you're listening to this, please just do this. And please do it right.
Okay. Here. How many times fucking Hulk Hogan died?
Oh, shit, son.
How many times has he been on the brink of death in that squared circle?
How many times has he fought a worldwide threat or a galactic threat?
Well, he's part of the new fucking world order.
He didn't kill me alone.
In front of 500,000 people at the Superdome.
Also, there was some talk about Sergeant Slaughter joining the other part.
He defended America from the Iraqis. Yes. All right? You know,
he's the Iraq true American.
He'll have the world championship if it weren't for Hulk Hogan.
We don't want that. Did Goku get us that? No.
Okay, everybody. Elimination Chamber this Sunday. Please watch. It's really good.
Is that the new pay per view for you
that's
there?
Nice pay per
view. Oh, so what happened with the Royal Rumbles?
What a roller!
That's how the kids say it, right?
What a roller coaster of emotions that was.
It was a yeah.
Was that one guy that you guys were making fun of on there? The guy who lost the title that day, like the day before it. We watched the fucking pay per view. I was over here. And it was like a lightweight guy.
Oh, Shinsuke. Oh, no, he wasn't on there.
Oh, okay.
No, it was disappointing. He wasn't.
Oh, okay.
No, new people, really. And then
did Stone Cold Steve Austin jump in there and give everybody the Stone Cold
Stunner?
That'd
be great. But no, Roman Reigns came out at number 30, and we all died a little inside.
Who's that?
Death from my heart. No, Roman Reigns is okay.
It's like if they tried to make Superman an underdog story.
Yeah, he never loses.
That's basically it.
Never loses against the singles. He has to be cheated upon. And then they were like, he's number 30. After he already had a fucking match that night, he came out limping and then fucking beat like six people, including The Undertaker.
Are you salty about this, bro?
Everybody is. Every wrestling fan ever. Well, I mean, not all of us, but most of us.
There's been a lot of wrestling talk on this podcast today.
That's a lot of what we do.
That is, yeah.
So, we're 3 weeks away from the Switch.
Can't get a pre-order.
I got mine.
You fucker.
I'm actually thinking of buying two in the line.
I would love you. I will pay you for the second one.
Well, I was going to make mad profit on the second
one. No.
That's how beautiful this is.
Yeah, I can't blame you on that.
Yeah.
I got like a email subscription to all of them, to Toys R Us, Walmart, Best Buy.
Yeah,
I'd love if it was Best Buy because I get a discount.
Here's the fucked up part about it. I went in 2 days later. Then Walmart started taking their pre-orders, and I was still the first person to put a pre-order in at our Walmart.
That's crazy.
I went in 2 days later.
Has there been any more?
Yeah, we sold out of pre-orders.
I'm not gonna stop buying Nintendo because I'm dumb, but I'm gonna be real mad if they have a shortage problem. There's no excuse.
If I buy two of those, I'm gonna have at least $1,000. That's
what I'm gonna have. There's no excuse for it at this point. There's no excuse.
I'll take a bet from you on that day.
They have the pre-orders. They know people want it. It's like the NES Classic. They knew people wanted that.
Yeah.
That's the point, though. If you sell out, you know, and the ones that you have left are gonna drive the price so up. So.
But then they're not making money on it, you know?
I mean, the NES Classic was cool.
The hype surrounding it, though,
I would rather see a SNES Classic.
Well, yeah. That's just me. Yeah, that'd be cool. Next Christmas, and nobody will buy one. Nobody will get one, sorry. Stay in line for... There's people standing outside.
Well, let's see. Trevor got one. Yeah, he was there, like, day one. We got six in.
We got, like, 10 in one time, and people just stood outside the line just... Like, overnight for that shit.
What?
I just wonder what Stadia meant.
I don't know.
I think you can, like, change around, like, your, like, colliding and stuff on the go and stuff like that.
I don't want headsets.
Yeah. You guys have anything else you want to talk about, or?
I don't have much of anything. Go on.
You nerds.
Fucking nerds.
Sorry, I don't get out of the nerds! House.
Let's see. I think it's RPG Now. I think that's the name of it, of the service.
Where people are going on making games?
No, it's like a D&D supplement kind of thing, but they've partnered with Wizards of the Coast. So now you can buy the books for your computer program, and it has like all the monsters in it.
You thinking about
D20?
Roll
D20. Yeah, roll 20.
Roll 20, that's it.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Really well.
They charge a lot of money for those, though. And, I mean, it's not. I'm not saying it's not fair, because you're buying the book, and that's...
It's about the same process as the book?
Yeah.
Did they come out
with
the new book last week?
I didn't mean to sound like it wasn't fair. You're paying the book price.
I think they came out with a new adventure. I think it was another adventure.
I thought it was
the Bolos came out not too long ago.
Yeah, which that thing looks sweet.
Was great, man. The old Bolo guides were top notch, and these especially. I haven't checked them out, but they seem like they're in the same.
Did spirit. You see their pop up book that they came out with? Their Monster Manual pop up book.
What?
It's fucking great.
That sounds amazing.
So like you have this is the book there, and like to say you're reading about vampires. Well, over in the corner might be like a letter. And it's like wax sealed, and you have to pop it open, and there's a letter inside of it.
Oh wow!
And it has like little pop ups. It's so neat.
That sounds cool.
Yeah, we saw them at over there at Barnes and Noble.
Huh?
They're really neat. Like the dragons, like you pop it up, and then the dragons will. it is neat. It was and it was kind of adult too. So it's like it's definitely not for kids, but it's neat.
That's cool.
It's a neat book for the D&Ds.
What the hell is a Bolo?
It's a guy.
It's a famous
explorer adventurer.
Rome's lore. Okay. That's how they did, like,
and,
the...
And he lies a lot.
So. Yeah.
Yeah.
He's very cheeky a lot as well. It's fun reading his descriptions of the towns.
Huh.
Yeah.
Look in
there. He's a bit of a character.
Fun. Yeah. That's one thing I feel like D&D has very few of is, like, memorable characters.
Well, you got
Dritzed and...
Fucking Dritzo Durden.
I don't know who else.
Dritz Durden.
I mean, Forgotten Realms is pretty deep, man. I don't know. Elminster and fucking...
Well, it's only if you... Well, yeah, I mean, I was about to say if it's only if you play the games, but... A big part
Elminster
of
can
Forgotten.
Kick the fuck out of Gandalf, just saying. No problem.
Gandalf's a fighter mage.
He is a fighter. Like a level one mage, too. He don't even cast good fucking spells.
No.
Saruman's like, ha ha, fuck you, bitch. I got way better spells than you.
Oh man!
Yeah, is that it? Are we plunging here?
Yep.
Yeah, I guess so. I don't know. Sorry, you should have looked at me.
I want to look at you. You have pretty eyes.
Oh,
thank you. So beautiful.
So no questions.
No,
nothing. Really? Lame. Tears. Right here. Cheers. Well, anyway, if someone is watching and you do have questions, shoot us an email. Joystick Unhinged.
Bound. Oh, come on.
You're not even trying.
Dude.
He's so old. I'm going to write this down before we start the park podcast.
Joystickunbound at gmail.com.
You have a Gmail?
Yeah, I have a fucking Gmail.
You have it.
They're not invite only anymore, bro. You didn't. It's been a long time since that.
You guys, yeah, we have a Gmail. So hit us up on that. If you have a question you want us to read on air, or send us a video, no dicks. No, we won't show those on air.
Well, now you're just going to get an avalanche.
Are they
interesting? Oh, it's okay. Like, I'll make sure I make fun of each of your dicks.
Oh, man. Oh, man.
So, hit us up on that. Matt, Captain Phipps, everywhere. CPTNFIPPS. Got Phipps.
Let's spell that again.
Nope.
Yeah, you go.
I'm Dexter Hawkins. On...
No, you're not. You're Andrew.
Okay, yeah, I'm Andrew, and I'm Dexter Hawkins on Xbox Live and on Twitch. Probably gonna stream some. Ready?
Slam Poet.
Tune in. I am Justin. Just on everything, so
he does slam poetry on Saturdays.
I am very active in my urban community, and
Justin, you're the least urban person I know.
He does pretty speak.
And now he's a gangster.
Now I'm not. So yep. What do you do now? Nothing.
You're right. You beat me. You got me, buddy.
Yeah. Oh, man.
You showed me.
I did. And that's just a fraction of my power.
But you're
it's not his final form.
He's not over 9,000.
You're Janzeth on the Steam, right?
On the Steam, on the everything.
He only has Steam.
He is the
I gotta there's maybe one podcast somewhere.
Somewhere in existence.
What are you gonna fucking do with it?
I played Pocket Minecraft on it for a while.
Oh, okay.
Without realizing that it was a Pocket Edition.
Wow.
Yeah, I'm an idiot.
He thought that was real Minecraft.
They might give him the slow clap.
That's what they were advertising on.
I remember one day Justin was over at the house, and I got a bunch of like extra cash something. Like I bought something, and they gave me money back on it or some weird thing. So me and Justin went into the, this is old Xbox 360 arcade, like the indie game section, and we bought like this horror game.
Oh man, the horror games were so awful.
We just made fun of them forever. It was funny. Like it was this chick like, walking around, and like you had to hit the right button combination or she died. And if you fucked up the button combination, she died no matter what she done. She would be like, I'm going to get a glass of water. What was that noise? You hit the wrong button? Like, she just, like, spooky ghost thing happens and you're dead. And it was stupid.
Wow.
It was really dumb.
It was a wonderful night, though. We've had a couple of gems in all that. It was mostly like it wasn't like the scary games. It was like the indie like little shooter.
Yeah. Remember the robot zombie one was all right.
That
one was pretty fun. It was all right.
Yes, I remember that.
But yeah, all of them were like 30 cents a game. Yeah. So we downloaded a bunch of them.
Yeah, at the most it was like a dollar.
It was a fun night.
Well, yeah, we got entertainment out of it, so you know it was totally worth a dollar.
Mm-hmm.
Probably the $2.35 we spent.
Well, I like to play bad games sometimes, so
as long as everybody should watch Thanksgiving.
Oh, Thanksgiving!
As long
gobble,
as
I'm... gobble, motherfucker.
You just got stuffed.
Oh,
God. I like playing bad games as long as I'll pay $60 for them.
Yeah,
that's fair.
Anything less than $5, I think, is fine for a bad game.
Yeah.
If you make a shitty game, just sell it for $5.
Yeah.
I'll play it all day.
Duncan, where can we find you?
I am mainly just on this podcast or online Xbox at Prison Sphinx.
Yeah.
Is all I do. I know how to do.
You play a lot of Warframe, so if you're a Warframe player,
yeah,
hit him up. Or you can send us an email and I'll send you some stuff too. Like I'm always on my emails. Is that right? Emails? Emails?
All the emails?
Matt is trying to stay relevant in
the technology world. Do you have an AOL? A Bell South.
Yeah,
Bell South.
Yeah.
I have an AOL disc in there. I'd love to give you
that. That's legit. He has an AOL disc in there.
Oh, God.
Sweet. If you want to
60 hours free.
Yeah, if you use it, I can get some hours
free. Right?
It's a crazy amount of hours.
So we should give that away on the cast.
Yeah, if you need 60 hours of free AOL time, please send us a 4-page essay
on why you need it.
Space.
No. Give us a 1-page story. Then email me a 1-page story about how Justin's gam is haunting. I want like a scary gam haunting.
I'm turning this into a comic book here.
That's what we need.
No.
And you can make it as hentai as you want.
Oh, oh shit.
If right. there is any sexual anything involving my grandmother, I don't know what I'll do, but it'll involve
you flip this.
This is getting awful. I'm gonna have to take so many flowers to their
grandmother. Spend a half hour. I'm sorry.
Yeah, it's just so many hours me just sitting there going, I don't have any problem.
It's the least you can do. We're sitting here, we start seeing those just start.
Ooh, spooky!
I feel like if it was going to happen, it would have done half before now.
I've done this. Oh, cute Pikachu DS comes out like next week.
I need that in my
Whoopee.
Life. I think I'll have taxes. No. I should spend it on that, but I want to.
Just don't do it, man. It's 220. It's 220 bucks. You can put an extra 80 with a Ghost Switch if you can find one.
Yeah, but I can't. So I guess I gotta resolve on a fucking 3S.
Oh, you can buy one on eBay for Matt for $500.
You're pretty sweet.
Yeah.
It would be a friend discount.
Man.
Less shipping, probably.
Yeah, no, no. Because this is like personal shipping. Like, I have to deliver it.
You don't it's have worse. To.
You could just add, I could just come get it.
Nope.
I know where you live.
No
you don't know where I live.
I know where you live.
I live right here, buddy. Right here.
Are you a ghost?
Ghost Matt.
This podcast is
real. Like
what?
Is that like Ghost Dad?
Yeah. I actually turned into Bill Cosby.
Oh, wow.
You're going to jail. You're going to jail.
You can't hold a ghost. There ain't no fucking Ghostbusters yet.
Oh, my God.
Ghost Bill Cosby's molesting everybody.
God.
That's why you brought out all the beer.
Yeah.
They just get us drunk and take it
and turn into Ghost Bill Cosby.
Oh my God. If we ever get big on this podcast, this episode's going to doom us.
Nah.
PETA's going to come after us. Bill Cosby's
a Ghost Bill Cosby.
I'll fight PETA and Bill Cosby.
There you go. All future aggressors.
This fucking fighting? Like 1920s pugilist?
Yeah.
Everybody having a holy day?
Yeah, I'm
having
a holy day.
You are a scoundrel, Bill Cosby.
We're going to go out in the yard and throw hands.
I don't think they said throw hands.
Throw them?
That sounds like a new thing. That's what they say now.
It
no,
looks.
Hell, that's old as hell.
It looks like you have overtaken
you sure?
me, Ghost Cosby.
Well, I'm not an old hand at it, but I'm pretty sure.
I think what they say is, catch me outside, how about that?
Yeah, I think that's pretty new.
Those aren't words.
No.
She came back on Uncle Phil. I don't know if you saw it. Uncle
Phil? She said, you mean Dr. Phil?
She said Dr. Phil. Like, there was a one lady that said, you're my uncle, right? That was the one lady that thought she was pregnant with Jesus.
Oh, God.
Oh, my God.
This is why I don't watch these shows.
Yeah, they're trash. But damn, it's a pretty good trash. Yeah.
Didn't she say that she made Dr. Phil famous by being on his show?
She did say that. She said, you was nothing for it. At first, she come out and there was no audience. She's like, we're all the hoes.
Well, how about that, chick?
Yeah, that one, because they brought her back. Yeah, because, like, you got to cash in on that again.
Well, yeah.
Yeah, because she got thrown off a plane.
She got kicked off a plane, yeah.
Like when it was in the air?
No.
I wish. We'd probably be better off as a race, but...
So much better off if that was the case, Matt, but that's not the case. She her and her mother got in a fight with another lady who called her trash, and... I don't really see how
she's wrong. How is trash like a word for fighting right now? Like, them's fighting words. You called me trash. Like, what? I don't know.
Because people like that girl just want to fight, I guess.
They want to go to the parking lot.
Man, yeah. Right?
Well, she's 13 and loves the attention. I mean,
she's like a girl. Yeah, not like a 20-something.
Yeah, she's 13.
Oh.
Is that how old she is?
Yeah, that shit.
That's insane.
I mean,
I knew she was young.
Yeah, some guy wanted to fight me in a parking lot because I made fun of him a couple of times. Like, he dropped a bunch of shit, and I was like, hey, man, you got to pick that up. and I walked around him. And then I came back and he picked up the same fucking box and dumped it out again. I was like, hey man, you gotta pick it up. You wanna go to the fucking parking lot?
When was this? Wasn't that work?
Does that work?
Was it one of the employees? What the fuck?
Hello, Jasper. Oh, man. Jasper and said, you gotta pick that shit up.
I don't put it past Matt.
That Jerry Preston loves to fucking.
Some guy trying to fight you over that?
Yeah. Hey, bro, you gotta pick that shit up. Yes. Right. Thanks for watching.
Yeah. I'm Robert.
Yep.
All right. See you next week.
Peace. Place